What up, Gavin?
What's up?
YouTube, say hello to Gavin. Do it now in the comment section. This tree's not gonna be that fun, YouTube. Here, I'll show you.
I mean, it's not gonna be super terrible.
So, for the first time ever, this tree looked a lot smaller here in person than in the photos. It looked bigger in the photos. But there's basically no tie-in point. I'm gonna spike up it, clear off these suckers here, and probably gonna top it and bring it straight down and use a tagline too. We'll do Gavin's method of a tag, and he's always wanting to tag everything. I know you're thinking, why don't you just put a tagline in this one? Oh, I know it. And bring it into the neighbors?
No, we'll pull it this way.
I think I might just take it to tree now.
When I think about it, I've been learning from you.
You know that mango tree? I was mini Trevor over there. I was tiny shit
with elf and shit.
I'm like, I see Trevor do this. I'm like, here, over here, and right here.
It helps to watch other people work, dude. Yeah, I learned span rigging off. Remember that guy?
Everything I learned. Myself.
Remember that guy who came to the job site the other day with his little girl?
Yeah.
Rion?
Yeah.
I learned span rigging from him. From one of his videos.
I'm telling you.
I watched one of his videos and I was like, whoa. I was like, that was smooth move, dude. Like, that was smooth. I want to do that. Well, it was like from a crane, you know? From a crane, I mean from a drone?
Yeah.
A drone video?
Oh, yeah.
So I could see everything. I was like, that's how that works. You just tied the one side off. You just tied the one side off and then attached it like a...
What was the name of that company?
What company?
The one you had to walk out.
Oh, I don't know.
I interrupt you like that. I just...
I don't know what company
was
that was.
Is it Julie's something?
I have no idea, dude. That kid found me on YouTube.
He
found me on YouTube and then I posted that video. So we're talking about that one job that I couldn't take it and I left. Or I didn't want to put up with it, or I forget what the title is.
Because of their experience.
Yeah, because Gavin watched that video. Everybody tells me that's one of their favorite videos. And it's like, it's the video where I'm being the meanest I've ever been to anybody on camera.
You're not even being that mean. You're just telling him the truth.
I know, but still, I was super like, you know. I never talked to anybody like that, really.
I know.
I try to be nice. And,
but it's like
this, you know, brother. This is a dangerous job, man.
Yeah, I didn't want to do it. I was like, no. But, you know, the kid even gave me $100. That job was 2 hours away.
Yeah.
I drove 2 hours to get there. So it took me a lot to leave. I didn't want to leave. I was like, I'm here. I don't have money, you know?
You were all set up already.
I know.
Breaking lights everywhere. I was like, oh my God.
He was all set up. Oh my God. What you were
saying? We were talking about that.
Yeah.
No, yeah, that's how I learned everything, though, by watching everybody.
Yeah, well, you get to see this. You get to see some of the stuff I do in person. It's not on video and shit.
The one guy I was telling you about, from Tyler, he fucking show up every Monday, fucking camera. Right?
Who, Jesse? Jesse?
No, the Spanish guy.
You remember Jesse?
Yeah, Jesse, yeah.
Yeah, he OD'd or something?
Yeah,
a couple months ago.
Song. I just seen Sean today, too.
Oh, really?
I'm on my way here. I'm on my way to pick you up. He was on key. I was actually gonna say hi to Sean. Fuck it. But I like passed him. Yeah. Yeah, that's crazy. But Sean's paying more now too. Apparently. Like the guys that work there, that be working there for like ever. Like,
yeah, you should go back. He's paying more.
I was like, that's how much I made. He's like, nah. Maybe I should go work with you. I was like, yeah.
This is a good company to work for. It small, is. But yeah. You have everything you need to be successful.
It is, yeah. You gotta know what to do. We're gonna throw a few guys. We're gonna throw a couple guys. You ain't been here. We're gonna throw like 4 guys. 3 guys. Anything we need. Anything one that's stuck around. Everybody calls.
them. We'll be implementing a few new rules here at Sherwood. A little pre-job safety meeting. There was an incident in Tampa yesterday. Did you guys see about it on the news?
No.
The guy had a lift. He's doing some repair work on the house. Hit the power line.
For real?
Dead. Yeah. Just yesterday. So.
Oh, it's pretty easy to do.
I think we're good here. We got no power lines. So.
No, I already did a visual. Yeah, I do a visual. Perfect. On everything. Yeah.
That's all.
Yeah, I do a visual and then I.
Our surroundings, bro. I don't, you know.
Dude's dead, bro.
Yeah.
Crazy.
It happens fast. I mean, it's. Life is crazy, bro. Life is a crazy thing.
Doing some repairs on a house and maybe doing
repairs?
Some. Yeah, they were fixing the roof or something and they had the lift up there and I guess it was. Right.
Too
so
close
to the power line that the machine touched the thing and...
That's why there's a minimum approach distance.
Was it two guys?
One guy died.
Oh, one guy on the lift.
I've seen the video there, like
so the minimum approach distance for us as tree workers
like
is 10 feet.
Yeah. 10 feet, man.
And that is a 10-foot wall. It's not a 10-foot circle around the power lines. That is a... So if there's a power line up there, we're not allowed to go within 10 feet of... Where it's under, right? And you're not supposed to have outriggers within that 10 feet. You're not supposed to have anything within that 10 feet.
And if you do, I think the truck needs to be grounded.
Do you know how many jobs that I get to? And a
ground strap straight to the truck. I think it should be grounded.
We did
That's
a one job
at Pike.
Where Tom was the one that ran the lift that day, but that shit was like right over the power line.
I've done a lot of jobs over power lines.
It all boils down to being complacent in your job, thinking, "No, yeah, this ain't nothing," you know, and then you get one last second, one win
to fucking lose the fucking branch.
Well, he's coming
one guy
down.
Texting on his phone, you know. One guy doing this, one guy doing that.
Yeah, I get a little complacent sometimes.
I think we all do.
And I have to go and watch some videos. And then I'll be like, okay. But I work a little differently than a lot of people. A lot of people don't agree with my working style.
Yeah, you get comfortable in your own style, but that's been, you know, like that.
I mean, I know what I'm capable of, but I'll get up there and, you know, if I gotta throw my climbing line around the limb, then if I feel comfortable in my position, then I'll unclip and then clip back.
That's like that situation with Rick Binder, you know? He was comfortable. He was a good climber, he knew. But he threw his buck strap on, and that one time it broke.
Yeah.
He fell off the fucking crane. You know?
Yeah.
Crazy.
Well, I do an inspection of my gear. I got a little...
That's the fault, you know. You can't fault the guy, but yeah, well...
I mean, I feel safe with this.
Has it got a cord in there?
There's a cord in there
still.
No, it's not steel.
It's not steel.
This is just a rope. But I'm comfortable with this.
I would change that.
Yeah, I probably should. But honestly, dude,
Your life is on that little fray right there.
But I mean, how often am I putting 100% of my load force on this? Ever. This is a positioning lanyard. So,
I really don't.
But I hung from two of these strands, two of them, and bounced up and down for a test, for a control test.
Really?
Yeah, I got it all on video. I posted a video on YouTube.
Wow.
Yeah, I hung myself, put on climb line, lowered myself down, and I took a razor blade and I just cut it.
Really?
Yeah.
See,
I cut it.
How much
I wanted to see, and I just once it broke, I went into a swing on my
on your other line.
On my other line. Two strands, bro. I was jumping up and down with all my weight on two of these on an old rope too, not a new rope. Haven't even started.
Trees have leaves. These trees drop leaves all day long.
Yeah, man.
It's fucking terrible.
It's the nature of the live oaks. They're evergreen trees, so they just constantly lose their leaves.
All the time.
Yeah.
It's like
there's nothing you'll be. You could take all the trees off of your property, and you're still get leaves.
You know what's the worst? The bamboo.
Oh yeah, the bamboo.
All fucking year.
Those things are gonna be terrible in about 2-3 years.
Really?
They're gonna be 50 feet fucking high. Yeah.
Really?
Dude, they grow like aren't 10 feet. They grow like 10 feet a year,
aren't
man.
They illegal?
What?
Aren't they like not even legal in Florida?
They're legal, but they're just what's the word for it? Invasive.
They're invasive, right?
Yeah, they're invasive. Little black eyed peas.
That's awesome. Okay. I got an outlet back there if you need an outlet.
All right. Yeah, I appreciate that.
Right behind the.
Yeah, I come with like. All the fucking chargers and everything. I appreciate it. Alright. Appreciate you, man. Thank you. Shit. Will you do me a favor? Will you just hand me that, bro? Thank you. That's the important stuff there. I need that. Everybody. You could tie that on, please. Thank you. Were you talking to me? Okay.
We were talking about you.
Oh, that's cool. Be careful if he drops it. So I think will you hand me that line? I'm gonna lower this piece down. I'm just gonna natural crotch it right here in front of me. Thank you. And that's how it starts. Maybe slide that plant out of the way. If it's possible. All right, Gavin. I'm just cutting this bottom one, tip tie. You don't need a rope.
Oh, you don't need a rope.
Maybe I was Maybe I was wrong on the tip tie. Jesus. All right, hang on a second. Let me cut and throw this other limb that's in the way. Jesus. Go ahead. Go down. Sorry about that. Sorry, guys. Man, I wanted that to be easy. I was like, I'll just tip tie, it'll be a lot easier. God damn it. Fuck. Yeah, I just keep slipping spike because of this stupid bark. Just scraped up both my arms. Really look professional up here, don't I? Sliding down the fucking tree. The bark is shitty on this. Yeah. I was like, this is easy.
Yeah.
Are you enjoying the snow?
Yeah. Dad, turn in. It's too late, bro. We gotta work.
The fuck am I listening to? Headache. Right in the gutter. not much of a tie-in point here. Like no tie-in point, actually. Like none. I mean, yeah, this is technically a tie-in point, but it's not like a good one. I have to come down and put a carabiner and a strap on my feet, so any rigging point that I have. Somebody needs to sharpen their spikes. Thank you. Oh, did the rope? Oh, the rope didn't fall. You're good. Yeah, you're clear. I tried to point it all the same way. I kind of not. The shitty tree, guys. This is a very shitty tree. I'm not a fan of these. Hey, what was that about? What was that about? The truck? What? Never mind. Oh, yeah, I know. Oh, God. I said this was easy when I was down there. I was wrong. I was wrong. That was a bad assessment. That was a poor assessment. Yeah, I'm not gonna tie in there. I'm just gonna fucking flip to it. That's probably a safer bet. All right, I'm doing this one little limb at a time because of space and shit. I don't know. Ready on the rope, no wrap. Small limb. Yep. Yeah, if you want, let it point down. There you go. Oh. It's all you, buddy. All right, I'll help you. No, not now. Ugh. All right, ready. Fucking wish I had some footing. Ready? I'm not. Give me 1 second. I was having a safety meeting. Are you ready? I can't see nothing. You ready? All right. Just hold it tight, okay? Okay, I have to.
All right, it's small. The last one I did?
Yeah.
It was just easier to tie. Yeah, that was a clove hitch. It's easy to get out. Yeah. Super small. Let it down, man. I know there's nothing you can do. Gavin, this one's gonna drop. Just hold it tight, okay? Small.